But there was this time a few years back when virtual reality was kind of sort of hip for a moment. Everybody was, oh yeah, VR is going to be it. And of course, it didn't turn out to be that way. But it sort of, had this kind of hip phase. And there was like the Oculus Rift and all this stuff was kind of just on the market and all these Kickstarter products. And so for some reason, I figured like, hey, you know what would be, I was thinking like, I want to do a new project, right? Everything was going like really well in my life. And I was like, ah, I want to do something new, something cool. So I more approach it from what would I like to do? Like, what kind of team would I like to lead for like a really cool, more bigger project? And I figured out I'm gonna make the first 360 movement chair, so you can really simulate like gravity and stuff. And when you play like a flight simulator or a car simulator, it'll like actually put the G-forces on you and everything. So I made this really cool design, and it was called Space Pilot. We named it Space Pilot. And so this Space Pilot VR simulator, and we had this whole marketing campaign called Space for Us All. This was also when Richard Branson had just announced his, what kind of came to fruition, the last week when he first went into space. And so we figured, well, a lot of people cannot afford a ticket on Richard Branson's ride, but they can afford a ride on the virtual simulator. So they can simulate going to space, and with the virtual reality goggles and the G-force simulator, it'll be like super real. And so I had this really funny, but there were a few like guys who were like experimenting with this in the, in the kind of the IT tech world. But all of those devices looked like, I saw one, I think on Shark Tank or one of those British entrepreneur shows, right? And one of the female sharks said, if my husband would show up with this thing at home, I would immediately divorce him, right? And it really made me laugh. And I was like, yeah, it's true, because all these things look so geeky and not cool and like full of wires and not well designed. So I figured I'm going to make this thing, like this simulator, but I'm going to design it like a Ferrari. It's going to look so cool that every girl is going to go, I want to go on there, right? Because then it'll be like, yeah, sure, why not? It's going to be a cool product. So the problem I was solving, like, no guy can come home with this, but I'm going to solve the problem so that when you come home with this, your girl's like, oh, that looks cool. I want to take a ride on that one, right? And you can actually, so I figured that would be the main solution to the problem. So I actually got, Guerrilla Games. And so they have their office in Amsterdam. And so through a friend, I got in touch with that team. And I actually got the whole, those guys all ready to like dive in and actually help us design the software and the hardware. Got everybody together, right? And then we started to really do some marketing research because this thing had to, cost at least like $10,000 or whatever. And you had to like create a whole room in your house to this device, basically, but looked super cool. And pretty soon we found out that people weren't really willing to dedicate a whole room just to their virtual flight simulator for their house. So that kind of finally ended the project, where it was just like, yeah, we could probably do this, but it would take us 10 years of really hard work getting this into the market, and then it would still only be like kind of like a billionaire's plaything or whatever. And we figured like, ah, it's probably not going to work, right? So the chance and also the VR technology, we're like, yeah, people are super hip about it, but we still don't see that becoming like a mass adoption thing. Wear the goggles, it doesn't really work. People are just gonna keep PlayStationing on a screen, maybe a 3D screen, but not with the damn goggles on, right? And so finally I had to scrap that product. And yeah, that I had to say goodbye to